What is going on, everybody? I am your host, Juice Wayne, and I have some exciting news to bring to you because Batman is joining the Crisis on Infinite Earths crossover on the CW. And I know what some of you are thinking. You're like, oh, Juice, I've actually read that article, and it's actually Kevin Conroy that's joining the freaking crossover, and it's actually not Batman. He's going to be playing Bruce Wayne. No, you are absolutely wrong because Batman is joining the freaking crossover. I don't care what you're saying. Batman is joining the crossover. And I don't care if you like Christian Bale or Ben Affleck or Michael Keaton or Val Kilmer or even George Clooney or Adam West. Kevin Conroy has always been Batman. He's the greatest Batman of all time. So Batman is joining the Crisis on Infinite Earths crossover on the CW. Bring it downtown. What is going on, guys? I had to just get that out of my system because, yes, Kevin Conroy is joining the Crisis on Infinite Earths crossover. Man, that is a mouthful to say. But yes, he will be joining the team with a whole bunch of other stars that are going to be a part of this crossover. It's actually got me really excited. I'm not caught up on these shows. I will be watching this crossover even though I'm not caught up. But still, we got freaking Batman joining the show. And yes, he is going to be playing Bruce Wayne from an older storyline that I will be talking about in a little bit. But I do think this whole concept is pretty cool. If you've been watching me for a long time, you know I always hated their kind of multiverse that they were building because it doesn't match the one from the comic books. I have a very infamous video called It Doesn't Make Sense that goes all the way back to Flash Season 2 where they just totally messed up the multiverse. Now, they have since corrected that, which I think they corrected it in Season 5. And I got so many like messages like, Juice, it finally makes sense. But now, since I already know that they finally made it make sense and there's all this craziness happening and anybody can be any superhero on any other world, I think this is pretty cool. But to finally have Kevin Conroy, the voice of Batman on Batman the Animated Series, which is still the greatest piece of Batman content in my opinion, I think this is epic. And I hope he gets to like at least punch somebody or do something because Kevin Conroy has been carrying the voice. He's been making Batman so great for decades. And I just really hope he gets his little bit of time to shine on the actual big screen. The only way you could make this Crisis on Infinite Earths better is if you brought in Mark Hamill to be like an older Joker or something like that. That would be really cool. And then they have like a little face-off going. That would be so just absolutely amazing. And now I know a lot of you might be confused or might be thinking like, oh my God, Kevin Conroy is going to be the Bruce Wayne from Batman Beyond. So maybe we're going to get Batman Beyond. And I don't really think that's the case, although that would be awesome if we did get Batman Beyond. I believe that they are going with the Kingdom Come Bruce Wayne. And if you've never read this story, it was drawn by Alex Ross, so you've probably seen the artwork before. But Kingdom Come Batman was just a lot of the superheroes were a lot in the, they were in older ages, they were all old, and Batman was pretty much like donezo. He's having to wear like a suit to actually help him get around. He's still able to do stuff, but he's not able to like really fight crime too much. Correction, there's still actually a Batsuit. I just don't think they would give that to Kevin Conroy in this sense, but I do think they will probably go more with the storyline of where he's kind of done. He's past his prime. He has to wear this thing all hooked up to him. Or maybe he's just an older Bruce Wayne, but I believe they are going to be going on along with the story that Kevin Conroy is just a Bruce Wayne past his prime that can no longer be Batman. Because you can see, we already know that Brandon Roth is going to be playing the Earth 2, or essentially the Crisis on Infinite Earths Superman, which is the gray-haired Superman. And you can see that gray Superman is actually in this comic book too, which is in the Kingdom Come storyline. So it's very possible that that Superman and that Batman are on the same Earth, which would be really cool. Not gonna lie, I'm pretty stoked for this because I'm so glad Kevin Conroy can actually be Batman on screen for once. I mean, or Bruce Wayne, whatever. It's better than just being behind a screen the whole time and just doing your voice, although he's been amazing at that. I'm glad he's gonna be able to have a little cameo. I always told myself that if I ever got to make a Batman movie, I was gonna have Kevin Conroy and freaking Mark Hamill make a cameo in that movie because they deserve it. They deserve to be in a Batman movie because they are the best Joker and the best freaking Batman of all time. That's really all I got for you guys. I know this video is really short, but this news was something that popped up yesterday and I was just like, man, I have to talk about this. So yeah, let me know your thoughts on Kevin Conroy joining the Crisis on Infinite Earths crossover in the comment sections down below. Do you love it? Do you hate it? Let me know. Guys and gals, if you haven't seen any of my past videos, please go check them out. We got some cool ones with a Batman update and freaking the failed Ben Affleck movie update. Go check those videos out. And if you're liking the content on this channel, please hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss any content on this channel. But as always, ladies and gentlemen, I am your host, Juice Wayne. Remember, when you wake up in the morning, ask yourself something about my daily dose of juice. See you guys next time. Bam!